Hey, what's up, people? This is Brian Gregg with another RWD screencast. Today is May 25th, 2017, and we are going to be talking about Vue.js. My last few screencasts were also about Vue.js, and we covered some of the basics on directives and creating components, creating your application, and two-way binding between your data and your form elements. And we talked a lot about reactive programming and how Vue enables reactive programming, but I didn't really demonstrate what that was. When we were demonstrating our previous examples, we were basically doing a form submission, but without the page refresh. So what I've done here is in this latest version of the code, we have created something that is going to demonstrate Vue's reactive capabilities. Just want to preface this. The code, the actual application was looking a little sloppy, so I went through and I cleaned it up. I added in Bootstrap just so that we can have something that's a little bit cleaner to look at. And we are going to be taking a look at these edit buttons that we put here. So very similar to what we had in our last example, we have our data set, which we're loading into our view object, into our my app ID, which we can see here is our my app. And we're loading in our data from our posts data set, which is this test.json. I will like to note that I added in an additional value into our each of our post objects, which is called isEdit. isEdit is just a flag that's saying whether or not the particular element in the page, the particular post, is in an editable state. So they are all set to false. But ideally, what we want to do is when we click on this edit button, for it to allow us to make changes to that message on the fly. So we're pulling that in as we were doing in our last example. We also have a object which is going to be used for anytime we add in a new message with the form at the bottom here. And we have the method for adding those elements. And I've added in two new methods. And they're very simple methods. They're really an edit method and a save method. The purpose of the edit method is when we click on this button, we want to set the isEdit variable to true, which basically puts the message in an editable state, and an isEdit false when we click on the save, which is going to put it in a read-only state again. And what we would like to see happen is we'd like to see clicking on this edit button to bring up a form that's going to give us a text box that's going to allow us to type our message in and for us to see that message change on our element on the page as we're typing it in. And that's what reactive programming is when you make an edit to something and it's immediately reflected in the DOM element on the page. So how do we do that? Well, we talked a little bit about the conditional directives in our first screencast. And you could see here in the last screencast, we took out all of that conditional logic. But I've put something in here now. So just as in the previous example, we have our posts. We have the post.header and the post.message. But now what we've added in here is a if directive, and that if directive is going to check that the current post, which is the post for the particular iteration within the list of all of the posts that were that's currently in scope, if that post is the isEdit variable is true, which we said was a flag that's going to be false by default, we will add in another input button on another input box onto our page, and it is going to model the post.message. Now, what does that mean? Well, that means that it's going to bind, just like we did the binding of the data in the form at the bottom of the page to the new element, this is going to bind our input box to the existing message. And the same as we did with the previous button element, we are going to do a vOn click directive, which is going to call our save post. And as we saw at the bottom here, the save post is basically going to put the object back into a read-only state. And then below that, we have the other condition, which is going to be the vif directive, not post.isEdit. So we're checking to see if the isEdit variable is set to false. Then we are going to display the edit button. So since, remember when I loaded in the JSON for these each had an isEdit of false, so the edit button is what's showing. Same thing with a new element. So adding an element is going to push the header and message from the text box that it's bound to, and it's going to automatically set the isEdit equal to false. So if we add something new in here, such as this is a new message, how are you doing? It's going to display the edit button. Now, when we click on this edit button, it is going to call this edit function, set p.isEdit equal to true, which is going to put this in an editable state. And now here's the money right here. We go and remove that, and you see that it's automatically reflected. This is a new message. And we can see that that changes automatically. Save, and we can go and edit another one. This is also a new message. Isn't reactive programming cool? So there we go. And you can obviously keep adding new things in here. This is more text. Hello. And do the same. You can edit those messages. And you can do more with, binding, in addition to just binding the message with the vmodel directive, you can model the header, or you can do whatever you want there. So I wanted to just wrap this up. This is going to be the last tutorial for this particular topic. If there's more interest in learning about Vue, I certainly have content for additional screencasts, but I'll be going back to some of the previous topics that I was covering in earlier videos on Phaser and D3, since there's a lot of demand for those. But if you do want to see more on Vue, or there's other topics that you'd like to see me cover on JavaScript and frameworks and technology and stacks, reach out to me on Twitter at IgnoreIntuition, or catch me in the comments. I'm always looking for feedback on the screencasts, and if these are providing value. So I want to provide content that's going to be most applicable to what people are interested in. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video. Thank you.